So a real wind turbine, if you look at it, it's going to take a bit of a wind speed started. Agree with that? So there is a region from zero wind up to a certain wind speed called the cut-in wind speed, where there's no power produced by the wind turbine. Also called the region one. Nothing's happening. Then, once the cut-in wind speed is reached, power ramps up, and you can now see that it's in an almost parallel slope to the power that becomes available with the wind speed itself, but it's only a certain fraction of that amount that actually a machine, a wind turbine rotor, can capture. And we're going to learn about how much that is. That region is called region 2. Power ramps up. So ideally, you want to produce power with wind turbines, want to make money, right? Want to sell the power. Ideally, you want to go all the way up here. But you're limited. What limits you? Generator. Okay, first thing that limits you is the generator. Generator can only take so much power and feed it into the electrical grid. So, you have to start controlling the power. That's the typical power curve of a modern pitch-controlled horizontal axis wind turbine. So you control the power by changing the blade pitch, changing the loads, and hence the torque and power produced of the rotor. So, that wind speed where you reach the rated power of the turbine and the generator, it's called the rated wind speed. And from there on, as the wind speed increases, we're going to see you have to pitch more and more the blades to accommodate for the fact that more wind power is coming in, but you can only, are only allowed to capture so much of that. So, essentially, you have to adjust the blade pitch angle such that local angles of attack acting on local airfoil sections become smaller, and hence the loads become relatively smaller, and the power stays the same. So then back at the end here, usually if the wind speed becomes about 25 meters, you have to shut down the turbine. Why is that? It's not a generator problem. Becomes a blade loads, becomes a load and fatigue issue. Okay? So if it's a storm condition, also in a storm you have more fluctuations of large amplitude, and that poses a problem. You have to shut down the rotor. So that's the cutout wind speed. So we're having these three distinct regions in the power curve of a modern pitch controlled horizontal axis wind turbine.